shows that we didn't have to leave it this long before this information came to our attention. In October 2007, the Audit Commission's attention was drawn to a number of concerns regarding aspects of council provision of services with adult social services and supporting people by passing law. In November 2008, a PEDA report into adult social services was published. And at that point, Mr. Deputy Mayor, you will remember that certain of those people were on the Audit and Management Committee will remember we raised real concerns others about what had gone on and why it had gone on and what was to be done about it. And events developed within that committee and things were set to manage that committee and to me personally, when I asked questions about what had gone on, that subsequently led to two senior members of the authority being suspended. We tried to have that debated in full council and we were not allowed to debate it at full council. In December 2009, Mr. Deputy Mayor, a red flag was awarded for the safeguarding for the council about the way it safeguarded its adults. In 2010, the CQC inspection found that Wirral was performing poorly in safeguarding adults, poorly in supporting adults with learning disability, increased choice and control, and the capacity of Wirral Council to improve was uncertain. In November 2010, adult social services was rated as one of the worst in the country by the Care Quality Commission. And of course, in September, Anna Klonowski's report into corporate governance was published along with a draft full report. Mr. Deputy Mayor, I really do regret the fact that opportunities were available to the council to actually make an intervention to prevent this reaching this particular point. Unfortunately, as a council, we were unable to do so. And I would say this about the particular action plan that Cabinet has agreed, we are receiving, if you will. I think we still need to make some effort to go through it to make sure it's responding to what's happening at the social services, as well as the broader corporate report that Anna Klonowski produced. I do think with all this mess, this scandal, there are opportunities for some thank yous, Mr. Deputy Mayor. First of all, I think there's a thank you to Anna Klonowski, aka, for the report they produced, the harshness of the report, and the clarity of the issues that it laid bare, i.e., people with learning disabilities overcharged for services, employees scared to speak up out against management for fear of reprisal, failure to tackle issues raised by employees, poor contract management of external providers of care. I thank Anna Klonowski, I think the whole council should thank Anna Klonowski for the clarity of her report. I think thanks are also due, Mr. Deputy Mayor, to Simon Madden, my colleague, for raising this issue and following up so tenaciously and to make sure that the issue did not go away. I think Simon has done an outstanding internal audit and those managing audits, Mr. Deckermeyer should have done better. Why did it take Martin Moore and Anna Klonowski to bring this matter, district auditor, to bring these matters to our attention? Why didn't we know already? What was going on that led that we didn't know? And Mr. Mayor, I do think could have done better. It does apply to the Labour administration in terms of the refusing to call for an independent inquiry when we suggested one, and also for being part of that, or creating part of that corrosive atmosphere that led to the fact that people did not feel they could raise issues, and the feeling that they could be treated in a way that was unfair. Mr. Deputy Mayor, I will conclude, and what I'll conclude by saying is that, as I said, this is interesting. I'm not sure if it reaches all the areas it needs to get. Mr. Deputy Mayor, I think I would be interested that the clerks make a note of all the comments members raise so that we can actually listen to and respond to the members of all sides of the council, having listened to any suggestions they might make. This is the first opportunity we've all had to actually discuss it. I commend and thank Steve Babbs and his colleagues for making sure that's the case. But there are a number of things that I am minded to do and will want to do at the first opportunity. We've already talked about continuing to work across the council to make sure we get an unredacted version of the report available to members and to the public. I'm minded to ask the officers to backdate the payment to those people the council ripped off from 2000 to 1997. And I think we should do that as a matter of I also think we should look to compensate those immediate families of the service users for the trials, tribulation, effort, emotion, stress that they have had to show in terms of supporting their loved ones, and also getting the council to pay attention and to pay notice to the way that their families have been treated. And I think we as a council should look to compensate those immediate families and the service users also. I've said already that I believe we should appoint an independent ombudsman that will be available to staff. And that independent ombudsman will be expected to put in place to allow council employees who feel concerns they raised in the past were ignored to speak out about any issues they have without fear of reprisal. Let us remember, Mr. Deputy Mayor, that it's only very recently that some of the most senior managers in DAS suddenly left. We have seen in the Martin Smith report the culture he describes of bullying, of authoritarianism, and of the people not feeling safe to come to the has come from the Klonowski report. There will be people in that department who feel they were unable to raise a point, or will have had their careers blighted because they sought to tackle the behaviour of some of the people leading that department or in senior positions within that department. I think we need a person outside the council who people can, who staff or even members, if they feel a bit wrong, should be able to go to actually have that investment, have that looked at, and where appropriate, investigated. And I also think that independent ombudsman should be available or should have the right to come to Employment and Appointments Committee and have the right to be heard, similarly to the way the head of internal audit has a right to be heard at the audit committee. And I think that would strengthen and give confidence to members of our staff that we are now changing the culture and encouraging people to come forward. And I've also